It's that time of the year again when new versions of point releases like Ubuntu and Fedora drop. Now, Fedora, to the best of my knowledge, had a pretty smooth launch, albeit a lot of work was done to make this possible. Over in Ubuntu land, however, whilst there is a lot of package updates and new features and nice new things you see in every new Ubuntu release, it wasn't smooth sailing for everyone. For Kubuntu users, Ubuntu 25.04 upgrade broke my system. Now I can't fix it due to broken packages. How to recover a Kubuntu 25.04 failed update. And this was not a one-off isolated case of someone losing power during an upgrade or their cat turning off their PC. This is a problem, resulting in something like this. A login screen, not themed correctly, and no desktops available to log into. And this doesn't appear to be a last-minute regression either, with Liam Dore of Gaming on Linux stating, "Upgrade to the new Kubuntu beta, didn't pay enough attention, and it clearly removed KDE entirely. Lol, oopsie." I like to live on the wild side, apparently. Writing in his article about all of this happening, "I actually encountered this bug during the beta, thinking I'd done something wrong or not paid enough attention. Turns out it was a real, genuine, major bug. I probably should have reported it, but I'm always doing multiple things at the same time and quite overworked right now. So, feel free to blame me, I guess. Developers can't fix stuff they don't know about. Whoops." Obviously, besides using Kubuntu, there is one thing in common in all of these cases. These are not Kubuntu clean installs. These are upgrades from a prior version of Kubuntu. This is a problem that specifically only happens in the upgrade path. And that perfectly explains why this was missed. Usually the upgrade process is considered to be, you know, relatively well engineered and just kind of working as you'd expect. And most developers are going to be testing the new version of Kubuntu, not upgrading from an old version to the new version. Same with any of the early beta testers. Most of those aren't installing it on their main system. They're going to install it directly on some test machine or anything like that, but not go through the upgrade process, just the clean install. Now, as funny as it would be to blame Liam for all of the problems here, is not exactly correct. Because back on April 1st, which is a horrible day to report anything, this problem was reported. They went through the installation process and wound up with a broken system. Now, at the time, this wasn't really given much attention. Someone came along to say, "Hey, can you provide more information, more logs, things like that?" And that's pretty much all that happened. It got a tag applied to it, and that is literally the end of the conversation. This is on the 8th of April, still prior to the release. Should it have been caught? Should there have been more testing? Yes, everyone thinks so. But there is a limited amount of people working on the project. Yes, it is Kubuntu. Yes, it is a major flavor, but it's not Ubuntu. It is not the main channel Ubuntu. It's gonna have a lot less people looking at it. People are gonna assume the upgrade process is fine, and you know, if nobody else goes and runs into a problem whilst they're developing it, no one's gonna take notice of it. Now, with a problem like this, it never falls to a single person causing the problem. But at the end of the day, somebody has to take responsibility for it and step up and say, "We're gonna get this fixed." And that is exactly what Simon Quigley of the Lubuntu project did. Even though it's Lubuntu and not Kubuntu, these are very much related here, and you could very well argue that this is his fault for this happening. Here's what's going on with this, because yeah, there's something going on. It's my fault personally, sorry folks. So when you go to upgrade from Kubuntu 24.10 to 25.04, the actual installer is grabbed as a tarball from the archive. In other words, Kubuntu's 25.04 upgrader is used to upgrade to 25.04 from 24.10. I don't know why he had to specify that. That is self-evident by it being an upgrader. I'm sure there's something he's trying to mean here. I don't know why he specified it though. Well, I ported the PyQt6 this cycle. A few weeks before release, I was pinged with someone notifying me that Kubuntu, Ubuntu Studio, and Lubuntu didn't come with PyQt6 installed. Literally installing PyQt6 should fix your issue, for now. If you run into actual issues with the Kubuntu install after upgrade, I'm much more concerned. Now, whilst he might have done the porting, and yes, if we go back to November, he was definitely involved in moving from Qt5 up to Qt6, as reported here by Phoronix. Obviously, other people are involved in that repo, other people are testing it, other people are using it. So whilst he might have been the one to push the code, you know, there are other people involved who could have spotted it, who ultimately didn't do so. We have a fix in the queue. Waiting, sitting. We had the release today, that being the release of 25.04, not the release of the fix. To the best of my knowledge, at least as of the time of recording, the fix has not yet been released. I'm surprised people are able to upgrade already, and if someone already enabled the upgrades without checking with me, I'm going to be unhappy to say the least. Usually there is a bit of a delay with the upgrade process compared to the clean install, because again, even if the upgrade process usually is fine, you want to double check it internally before you release it to everybody. Some cross-training is happening, we are working it out. For now, this was me. Sorry about that, folks. Now, it turns out that was a problem. It was part of it, but it wasn't the only problem. People installed the package, it didn't fully fix it. And shortly after, Simon made a follow-up post. Hi folks, just a quick update on the latest. Yes, 25.04 upgrades are broken beyond just adding PyQt6 as a dependency. While I had something to do with that, there's a much greater issue at play that we don't know yet. There have been separate reported issues like this one here, but there's not really a good general tracking issue for what is actually happening here. It's a bunch of disparate, kinda connected, kinda related issues. From everything I can possibly read, enabling upgrades this early was a genuine mistake not found in code review. I have done everything in my power to slam the brakes on the upgrades, not just for Kubuntu, but for everyone, all 10 flavors, plus desktop and server. So, at least as of the time of recording, you cannot upgrade Ubuntu. You can install 25.04 as a clean install, but you cannot go through the upgrade process on anything just in case something else is broken. Yes, I personally pushed the code change, disabling those upgrades. It required one more manual step, and now it's deployed. As of about 20 minutes ago, I've passed off to the official Ubuntu release team who will now drive this to completion. The change I made was to mark Plucky, that being the new version, Plucky Puffin, something like that, 25.04, as unsupported temporarily, which will halt the upgrades with a possible side effect of an end-of-life pop-up on your Plucky machine. Basically, it's taking the new version and immediately marking it as EOL, which blocks the upgrade process, which I guess is a neat way to be able to handle that internally. Anyway, ignore the pop-up, it was just the quick solution to throw a wrench in the gears. I am genuinely sorry about this, on behalf of Ubuntu, on behalf of Kubuntu, and on behalf of my own flavor, Lubuntu, this is unacceptable, and I'll be persistent in making sure our processes become better. I'm going to try to go to sleep now. This thread is what alerted me that there is a wider issue specifically. So thank you all. We'll be better. If you need help picking up the pieces, yes, we have support channels for basically everything. The best thing is just make sure the Kubuntu package is already installed. I hope you can understand my position. I have never worked for Canonical. I work for Alterspeed Technologies. Please go support the Ask Noah show. Noah is the one who made sure I had enough coffee to survive this thing. Now, whilst it might be an issue to mark it as unsupported, causing weird pop-ups, causing weird support emails, being like, I just installed the new version and it says it's already end of life, what's going on? I think that situation is a lot easier to handle than I installed the new version through the upgrade path, I don't have a working desktop, I don't know what to do, how do I fix my system? One of those takes a bit less time to explain. Now, considering the upgrade process has been halted, no new users are going to be affected. If you happen to have a broken system you want to go and repair and not just do a clean install of Kubuntu or a clean install of another distro, I will leave this post linked in the description down below. Basically, it comes down to going into recovery mode, making sure networking's enabled, running a few commands, and pretty much you'll be good to go. Again, it's been like 3 or 4 days, so if you did do this on a production machine, well, either you're not doing much production, or you probably already fixed it with something different. Again, don't be worried about using Kubuntu 25.04. If you want to use it, that's totally fine. The release is fine. Only the upgrade path is broken. All clean installs, at least, that we're aware of right now, you know, maybe something is broken there, but at least from the knowledge available right now, clean installs, no problem. If you don't want to clean install and you're waiting to do an upgrade, this Ask Ubuntu thread is probably the best place to watch. When things are okay, when things are ready, an update is going to be posted here and you'll be good to go. The whole process of fixing things has been a tad delayed though, because of this whole thing called Easter and public holidays and people not working. So, you know, this isn't a perfect time to do releases. Usually when things go fine, it's fine. But if there's something that goes bad and the release happens to fall on one of those years where it is directly on top of Easter, well, we get this. Now, Ubuntu is obviously very important. Ubuntu is obviously very big, but this should give you hope that even if you make a mistake, you know, it's not the end of the world, because even something as critical as Ubuntu can have a completely busted release. So if you happen to have a bad release, you happen to have a bad update, it's not the end of the world. Even the biggest players in this space can make major mistakes sometimes. But let me know your thoughts down below. Were you affected by this problem? Did you try to upgrade Kubuntu and things just broke? Or did you want to do an upgrade, realize the upgrade wasn't available, and then got very confused and start searching online why this is happening? You somehow wound up here. I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribe, Silly Barrow Pay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me and... a book.